With the release of Fortnite Chapter 2 comes all new locations, mechanics, and much more, including all new landing spots and new POIs. I'm sure by now most of you are wondering which places are the best for loot, rotations, and those easy wins. And that's why we've made this video to loop you in on all the latest locations and best drop spots. We know how difficult it can be to learn everything about the new map and figure everything out, so we've done all the work for you. What up guys, it's your host Dan, and in this video, we're going to be counting down the top 5 landing spots in Fortnite Chapter 2. But before we get into it, if you guys are interested in getting better at Fortnite, then click the link below and go to ProGuides.com, where you can play with the best players in the world by just clicking a button. Sign up for our memberships at ProGuides, and you'll get a ton of incredible content from the best pro players, like Benji and Mongrel. So if you want to compete in Fortnite, you have to check out ProGuides.com. Also, be sure to drop a like on this video to show us your support. We strive to bring you the best content available, and the likes really help. Alright, with all that being said, let's get into the video. First off, we have Retail Row. I love Retail Row. Do you love Retail Row? Retail was always one of my favorite spots to land in Chapter 1, and I was honestly a little scared to lose it in Chapter 2. Luckily, Retail has remained in the game. Now that the annoying zombies are gone from Retail, it's an amazing spot to land at. Why, you may ask? Let's find out. Generally, when you land at Retail Row, you'll get anywhere from 0 to 10 players landing with you. If it's at the beginning of the bus path, you'll likely be heavily contested. However, if Retail is far away from the bus path, it's the best time to go. Think about it this way. Nobody wants to waste their time gliding halfway across the map. They want to get into battle. That's why if you go for a long glide and hit up Retail, you'll likely get it uncontested. Plus, if you really think about it, what are the chances somebody wants to land at a heavily contested spot, especially in scrim matches? Players will likely go here to Pub Stomp. So you're probably wondering, what's so great about this place? Well, for starters, Retail has 16 total chest spawns. So now the chests have a 100% spawn rate in Chapter 2, you're pretty much guaranteed amazing loot. Tell me that's not the best change to combat RNG. On top of this, Retail contains a bunch of floor loot spawns. So even if you don't get lucky with the chests, you'll have backup from the floor loot. But wait, there's more! On top of having a ton of floor loot and chests, Retail also has the potential to spawn 7 of the new super chests, which drop guaranteed epic and legendary loot. These are so awesome, since normal chests no longer drop any loot with higher than blue rarity. If you're ever contested in Retail, my advice would be to back off and loot more. Then push when your enemy doesn't expect you to. One great thing about Retail is how large it is and how much space you can get. If you don't have good enough loot, you can easily back off before your opponent gets the jump on you, get more loot, then head back in and get them when they don't expect it. Alright, moving on to our next insane location, we have Holly Hedges. The best way I can explain this next location is that it's basically the Greasy Grove of Chapter 2. From the layout, to the loot, to the location, it's all so similar. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we're talking about Holly Hedges. Holly Hedges is a great drop spot if you want to get a lot of wood and a fair amount of early game fights. One of the best parts about Holly Hedges is right there in the name, the hedges. You can easily get max wood in a few minutes just by farming the hedges which surround it. On top of that, the cars in the streets make for an easy source of metal. And if you know me, you know that I love me some metal when I'm playing Fortnite. On top of having awesome materials, the loot at Holly Hedges isn't too bad either. While it isn't the greatest loot on the map, it's definitely pretty solid and can give you a nice path to endgame. Holly Hedges has 6 super chests, which will give you some good epic and legendary loot, along with 11 normal chests and a bunch of floor loot spawns. The only bad part about this spot is that it doesn't have any really good rotations apart from going southeast towards Weeping Woods, which makes it tough if you get a far storm circle. But if you're willing to risk a far zone and want some great materials and a fair amount of kills, Holly Hedges is worth a shot. If you're a camper like me and don't like to fight early game, this next spot is just for you. One of my personal favorites and one of the best spots on paper is the Slurpee Swamp on the bottom left corner of the map. Slurpee Swamp is an interesting spot with a lot of features quite different from most places. The loot isn't amazing, but it's made up for with boats, fishing, slurp juice lakes, and consistently quiet early games. The first thing that comes to mind when I think of Slurpee Swamp is, well, believe it or not, fishing! I love being able to grab a fishing rod and hang out on the edge of the map, watching the kill feed as my odds of winning get higher and higher and higher. This is one of my favorite spots due to the fishing aspect of it. Not only is it peaceful, but you can also catch fish, which can be used as healing items. If you catch a slurp fish, hold on to it, because it gives you 50 health instantly. Plus, you can carry up to 3 of them, which should be achievable with 2 or 3 minutes of fishing. Having 150 basically instant health in your inventory can be super useful later in the game. All right, enough about fishing. Sorry, I don't know why. I just love fishing for some reason. The second reason that Slurpee Swamp is a great spot is the boats. Since Epic added boats to the game, locations towards the edge of the map are much more viable since you can hop in a boat and rotate faster. On top of that, boats carry unlimited rockets, which deal 35 damage each. Finally, the last great thing about Slurpee Swamp is the guaranteed health. Slurpee Swamp is full of slurp lakes, as players like to call them. Basically, standing in one of these lakes will give you an effect exactly like a slurp juice, granting you 2 health every second. It's a great way to top off your health and shield coming out of a fight, or to get maximum shield off spawn. If you can't already tell, I love Slurpee Swamp, and I think you probably would too. With fishing, unlimited HP, and boats, it's too good not to put on this list. Number 2, Pleasant Park. Good old Pleasant Park. It's been here since day one, and it hasn't left us yet. It would be absolutely ridiculous to leave Pleasant Park out of this list with the awesome stuff it can provide. One aspect of Pleasant Park that's always overlooked is how spread out it is. Just take a look at it and see for yourself. If you get a house to yourself, you've likely got a few minutes to loot before you have to fight anyone. Having Pleasant Park all to yourself is definitely a rare occurrence, so don't count on a quiet early game. But if you can get out of Pleasant alive, you'll be completely set. The great thing about Pleasant Park being so spread out is that you'll be able to loot up quite a bit before you get into an engagement, minimizing RNG and increasing the chance that you make it out alive. The best spot to land if you're trying to play it safe is the Modern House. This house used to be destroyed in Season 10 of Chapter 1, but has recently been rebuilt and almost nobody lands there. It contains a chest spawn and a spectacular amount of floor loot, so you can make your way around counterclockwise to loot and stomp anyone in your path. It also provides a really easy way to escape if you need to, as it's not as close to the other neighboring houses. One more plus of landing at Pleasant is that you'll consistently get a lot of wood and a fair amount of brick and metal if you spend a good amount of time farming. Pleasant is basically a wood paradise, having hundreds of fences and a bunch of trees all around. To get brick, you can break parts of houses or the gas station. Finally, for metal, you can break a bunch of cars in the streets. Overall, you can easily get max wood, 500 or more brick, and 500 or more metal from Pleasant. It also provides a vast amount of loot and can be enough for a full squad if needed. Assuming you survive Pleasant Park and clean up all the loot from it, you'll have the loot from 17 normal chests and 6 epic chests, and you'll also be able to head to the Red Bridge and grab a boat to rotate quickly if the storm is far away. So overall, if you want some fun non-RNG early game fights, along with great loot and spectacular amounts of material, make your way down to Pleasant Park. Alrighty, we're down to the wire. For our number one spot, we have Sweaty Sands. Life's a beach over at Sweaty Sands. Beach pun. Do you like that one? No? Alright. I won't do it again. Life's a beach over at Sweaty Sands. I lied. Anyway, the number one spot in our list is held by Sweaty Sands. Sweaty is the best place on paper, having 25, yes, I said 25 chests and 10 super chests. I don't know what's up with this place, honestly. I guess Epic just said, let's put as much awesome stuff as we can in this one tiny location. As if having 25 chests and 10 super chests wasn't enough, Sweaty Sands also has a ton of wood, a ton of brick, and a ton of metal. Grab some wood from the trees and the wood truck, grab some brick from the walls of almost every building, and grab some metal from either the cars in the streets or the Frosty's ice cream shop. On top of all this amazing stuff, Sweaty also has a campfire where you can heal up after your fights, because there will be a lot of them, and a boat spawn so you can rotate out quickly. The zone will usually be a bit far, but having the boat will help with that a ton. My favorite strategy when I land at Sweaty is to land on top of the hotel, where there are 2 floor loot spawns, and try to get a few easy kills on players gliding in or fighting in the streets, and make my way down through the rest of the hotel for the awesome amount of floor loot, the 4 chests, and the 2 super chests. Once I finish that, I head back to the top to scope everything out and third-party my enemies when they don't expect it. The one downside to Sweaty is that you'll run into a bunch of players, as the name somewhat suggests. However, if you hold your high ground on top of the hotel and play it smart, you'll be able to win the spot every time. There are a lot of awesome spots in the Chapter 2 Fortnite map, and one important tip is to experiment and see which one that you enjoy the most. Here's a short summary of what playstyle best suits each location on this list, so you can get a better idea of which spot is your type. If you like average early games and a bunch of space to loot, give Retail Row a shot. If you want max wood and want an intense early game, make your way over to Holly Hedges. If you're the quiet guy who likes to fish and relax in peace to start off a game, Slurpee Swamp is a good idea. If you like early game fights but hate the risk of RNG, glide on down to Pleasant Park. Finally, if you like to frag out and get insane loot, your spot is Sweaty Sands. Whichever spot you choose, remember that it's important to practice, practice, practice. The reason pro players are so consistent early game is because they know the ins and outs of their drop spot. go into Playground and memorize the loot spawns for your spot so you can have consistently good loot and a better chance to survive into the mid game. Thank you guys all for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, click the thumbs up button and leave us a comment. I'd like to hear, what's your favorite landing spot on the new map? I look forward to reading which ones you guys like best. Who knows, I might even give some of them a try. Also, let us know what you'd like to see next on the ProGuides channel. Thanks so much again for watching, guys. See y'all out there soon.